A couple of key things happened to make me want to lose the weight. One of them is that I was watching The Biggest Loser while eating some really delicious Ben and Jerry's cookie dough ice cream. Right? Okay, I love you people already. You're with me. Shit's amazing, right? And I'm eating, and this lady is on the television. She looks really unhappy. Like, she's really miserable, and she's really big, and she's crying about how she's going to die because she's so fat. And I'm eating my ice cream going, man, she's got it bad. She's, like, having a hard time. And then she steps on the scale. Boop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop. She's 1 pound less than me. I'm like, oh, shit. As soon as I finish this ice cream, it's getting real around here. Second thing that happened is, even though I was a big girl, I always loved adrenaline sports because I like to hurl myself at small people because right before you hit, their eyes get big. It's exciting. So I always kind of like to do some fun sports and that kind of stuff. And my girlfriends invited me to go whitewater rafting with them. Like, would you like to go whitewater rafting? I'm like, that sounds amazing. Let's do this. And so we flew to Charlotte, North Carolina to go whitewater rafting at the U.S. Whitewater Center where the Olympic team trains. Super cool. Unfortunately for me, it's also super professional. So despite the fact that I am quite floaty, they insisted, actually they require it, that you wear a wetsuit. I had spent my whole life avoiding that action. Like, oh, right. And we're standing in front of this guy who's had way too many pot brownies. And he goes, what size suit do you need? And I'm like, 2X, 3X, Orca, what do you got? He's like, wetsuits don't really come in sizes per se. They come in heights. It's going to stretch to fit. I'm like... I don't think that's how science works. Why don't you give me the tallest wetsuit you have? So he hands me a 7 foot tall wetsuit. Guess they had basketball players go there, I don't know. And I'm dragging it into the locker room with my two girlfriends, Natalie and Laura, who are wonderful, wonderful friends because they were with me the whole way as I easily slid the wetsuit up over my knees and then reached a problem area. So Laura is pushing down on part of my butt that I don't know exists because I don't have mirrors that show me bad news. She's pushing on that part, and Natalie is working on the front flubs. And I am holding a neoprene torture device and trying to wring it over the flubs, like really hard. And I pull on it so hard that my fist comes off the wetsuit and pops Natalie right in the mouth. And she's bleeding from the mouth. And she goes, don't stop, you're almost in. That is not something you want to overhear in a locker room. Especially when there's blood on the floor. It's not a good time. And then the skinniest woman in the world walks by, already in her wetsuit. And she looks down, literally right across from me, and goes, oh my God, mine is just starting to pop open. I'm like, what? She didn't have one bit of pressure on any part of her suit, and I was rocking 60 PSI. I'm like, I am going to Ursula the Sea Witch all over this boat.